Well, how's it going for him? Great to have your company once again. Yes, I've been looking forward to this video. Yes, indeed I have. Here we go with the truth about the Mavi Marmara. There's been a lot of speculation. There's been a lot of stories. There's been a lot of propaganda about what
happened.
That was the attack in international waters where they took over the boat of the international flotilla that was bringing aid to the Gazan people. It was stormed by Israeli SAS commandos. It opened fire on unarmed people. However, the story that was released by Israel was certainly a different one to what actually happened. Well, here, listen up as I present the truth about the Mavi Marmara. To listen to the Israeli side, the Israeli version of events, you would hear of a desperate people in a desperate struggle for their very existence. You will hear the fact that they needed to abort these people. They needed to board the boats in international waters to save themselves for the rockets that were being fired on them from the Gaza-occupied territories. Nothing could be further from the truth. The truth about the Mavi Marmara is that the waters around Palestine, the waters around Gaza, have a huge deposit of both gas and oil reserves, enough to last Palestine for 100 years. When the huge deposits of $3 billion worth of gas and oil was first found back in 2000, it sparked hopes for peace negotiations between Palestine and Israel. It sparked hopes between the two. Talks started, eventually breaking down. By 2005, Israel had decided that Palestine, well indeed Hamas, had held hostage their gas and their oil long enough, and had begun their campaign of terror, even targeting the families on the beach of Gaza with their artillery shells. This was a sign to say, this is our land, this is our gas, do not mess with us. We are now stamping our foot down on our authority on this land. Even further displays were evident, firing upon Gaza fishermen as they went about their daily business, making sure their lives were one permanent hell, under fire constantly by Israeli authorities in their own Gaza territorial waters. This was a sign that they wanted not only the waters, but exactly what was underneath them as well. By 2005, Israel had decided that Hamas had held hostage their gas and begun to make plans on how to take it by force. Thus, Operation Cast Lead was born. When the Mavi Marmara left, it was not only searched by Greek authorities, it was searched by Cypriot authorities, it was searched also by Turkish authorities. All along the way, every single boat had been searched thoroughly for weapons and, indeed, contraband. There is no way any of these aid agencies would have put their names to this kind of activity. So they made sure that none of the boats were partaking in that kind of smuggling. As early as the 21st of February, Israeli national news, the Arutz Shiva, was reporting that 20 ships headed for clash in Gaza. They were already threatening that there was going to be a clash if these ships had announced that they were heading towards the Gazan port. With time closing in, the Knesset met for 2 weeks behind closed doors to talk about what to do behind the flotilla that was heading towards the coast of Gaza. Whatever they decided, the ultimate plan was to release this footage of them being attacked, and of them holding paintball guns. The whole idea was to downplay the significance of the SAS attack with real live bullets and ammunition. So they managed to stage the Mavi Marmara attack. That much is for sure. Some bloggers actually found that the boat that was used was not the Mavi Marmara in the video that they released. So what exactly was the boat? Well, as it so happens, the Mavi Marmara has a sister ship called the TBI Carradines. That's right, an exact replica, identical sister ship that doesn't have the name on the side when looked at from the other side. The whole idea being to seize all of the media equipment from all of the bloggers, from all of the TV cameras, from everybody on board, from on board every one of the ships in the flotilla. That way, controlling all the media going out, that way they could produce every little bit of evidence to say that they were the ones under attack and that they had only used paintball guns, downplay it completely. But in the meantime, get away with complete murder. Now, how do we know this? Israel have also admitted that they were the ones who actually started to sterilize all the clothing to release all the DNA evidence to all the fragmentation evidence and all the gunpowder evidence of the assassinations that took place on the Mavi Marmara and the other flotilla ships. We also have the incredible evidence discovered by Gordon Duff from VeteransToday.com. Do check it out. Some amazing evidence to show that the Israeli evidence video was actually produced under a green screen production. Oh wow, there's more. This was incredible. This actually shows that the video production was rushed and indeed an amateur production, much like they did on 9/11. Similar kind of green screen. Well, make of it what you will. But nevertheless, it's very interesting to show that the whole thing was a fraudulent video production aimed at discrediting the legitimate Gaza peace movement. See, my friends, the truth about the Mavi Marmara is that Israel is stamping its authoritative boot all across the land of Palestine, and indeed across Lebanon, and what it can get in parts of Egypt and wherever else it can get it. You see, a greater Israel has no borders, it knows no borders, and your borders could be next. That's it for today. Take care, and remember, the truth is not what you're told on the media. The truth is out there, but you've got to dig for it. You've got to find the links, and the links are all in the information bar. Take care, God bless, and ciao for now.